Bienvenidos a la sala de conciertos de la Biblioteca Luis Ángel Arango, un espacio del Banco de la República. Nuestra temporada digital continúa hoy con la presentación de Ben Goldscheider, intérprete de corno francés, en compañía de la violinista Savitri Grier y del pianista Tom Poster. Goldscheider es considerado como una promesa para no perderse por BBC Music Magazine y Gramophone Magazine. Debutó recientemente con la Orquesta Mozarteum y la Royal Philharmonic Orchestra. En este concierto escucharemos obras de compositores exponentes del romanticismo, un periodo de la historia cultural que es generalmente identificado en el ámbito musical con todo el siglo XIX y las primeras décadas del XX. El romanticismo se caracteriza por ser un movimiento en el que la expresión individual florece, dando oportunidad a los autores de experimentar y romper con algunas normas propias de la tradición musical europea. Uno de los personajes más representativos de este periodo es Ludwig van Beethoven, reconocido por ser uno de los primeros compositores en romper con el legado del periodo conocido como clasicismo, y de él escucharemos la sonata Opus 17. Escucharemos también el Adagio y Allegro Opus 70 de Robert Schumann y el Trío para corno en Mi bemol mayor Opus 40 de Johannes Brahms. Espero que disfruten este concierto interpretado por los músicos británicos Ben Goldscheider, Savitri Grier y Tom Poster, y que fue grabado en Stapleford Granary en Cambridge, Reino Unido. Bienvenidos.
Hi, I'm Tom Poster.
I'm Savitri Grier.
I'm Ben Goldscheider, and we are so happy to be playing this special program for the audiences in Colombia, which has been commissioned by the Banco de la República of Colombia. Well, the Beethoven Horn Sonata is a piece that, as a horn player, you learn pretty early on in your studies because technically it's not that challenging. It doesn't have a huge range like perhaps some of the more difficult works in our repertoire, like the Strauss Concerti. But at the same time, it's Beethoven, and there are endless layers, therefore, of musical challenges that you have to unlock. And so I kind of have been very interested to see it develop from a technical study when I was 10 or 11 to playing it now in concert. So it's been quite a big journey.
The Schumann Adagio Allegro is one of my real desert island pieces, actually. I've just always adored this piece. It speaks so honestly and so directly from the heart. Schumann wrote so much wonderful chamber music, but it's amazing to have this piece for this combination of horn and piano. I have to say I've played it much more with cellists. Cellists tend to steal it from horn players rather a lot, but actually it's when you come to play with the horn, you realize it's just so idiomatically written. I mean, it's a huge challenge for horn players, but it's, you know, the Allegro is just such kind of obvious horn music that, you know, I think it's the only way to do it, really. So it's just such a joy to play it with Ben.
The Brahms Horn Trio is one of my all-time favorite pieces. It's actually, though, as a violinist, it's not a piece that we get to play very often. There's much more other chamber music that I get to play, but it's like it's such a joy to play with Ben, to play with Tom. This combination of the violin, the horn, and the piano, three such very different instruments that, I mean, we were saying earlier, it's really the only piece of this combination, sort of from the Romantic classical world, basically until the mid-20th century. The sonorities that we can find together, I mean, and aside from the fact that it's just amazing music, I think we've all had a lot of fun putting it together and hope we could do it more often.
I think the best part about playing here today with Tom and Savitri at Stapleford is simply that it's not a secret how difficult the last kind of year has been, and to come together in a special setting with such forward-thinking programmatic ideas is a really special thing for us to do, to be able to meet and rehearse and not know if it's the last time for 2 or 3 weeks. It adds a special element. So to be here, to know that the audiences on the other side of the world are going to enjoy our music when they can't in person, I think is a very special thing. ¶¶
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Esperamos que hayan disfrutado de este concierto. Estén atentos a la publicación de más videos y conciertos en los perfiles de Banrep Cultural en YouTube y de Sala de Conciertos Luis Ángel Arango en Facebook. De igual forma, los invitamos a conocer nuestro podcast La Música se Habla, disponible en Spotify, Podbean, Deezer, Apple Podcast, Amazon Music y Google Podcast. A escuchar nuestras listas de reproducción en Spotify y hacerse socios de la red de bibliotecas del Banco de la República, para así tener acceso a valiosos recursos como la biblioteca musical de Naxos y las transmisiones de conciertos, óperas, clases magistrales y documentales de Medici.tv. Toda la actividad cultural del Banco de la República está disponible en nuestra página web, www.banrepcultural.org. Hasta la próxima.